Both Google and Bing are two popular search engines that are used by many computer and smartphone users. How do they both compare? Welcome to the BizPage channel. In this video, we will be looking at the histories of the search engines Google and Bing, to see how they both differ. If you haven't already, then be sure to leave a like on this video and subscribe to the channel for more valuable content and insights. Now without further ado, let's dive in. Let's start by looking at the history of Bing. In the year of 1998, Microsoft originally launched MSN Search. This was done using search results from Inktomi. This platform consisted of a search engine, index, and web crawler. In the beginning of 1999, MSN Search launched a version which displayed listings from LookSmart blended with results from Inktomi. It was at this time when Microsoft was making large investments in online web search by building its own web crawler for MSN Search. The index for this was updated on daily or weekly intervals. The upgrade began in the form of a beta program in November of 2004. In the year of 2005, it came out of beta form. At the time, any image search was done by PixSearch, which was a third-party platform. The search results were also starting to be provided to other search engine portals in order to compete in the market and stand out against rival companies. In March of the year 2007, Microsoft decided and announced that it would search developments would be separate from the Windows Live services being provided. This service was renamed and branded as Live Search. Following the separating, Live Search became linked into the Live Search and Ad platform that was ran by Satya Nadella. This was also part of Microsoft's Platform and Systems division. Live Search also joined with Microsoft Ad Center. A year later in May of 2008, Microsoft made another announcement, stating that Live Search Books and Live Search Academic would be stopped. This was to be combined into the regular search platform. This discontinuation also resulted in the closure of the Live Search Books publisher program. Within the same year, Windows Live Expo was also halted, along with Live Search Macros. In May of 2009, another service was shut down. This service was Live Product Upload. Earlier in the same year, Live Search Q&A was rebranded as MSN Q&A. However, this service also ended in May of 2009. Within the same year, Bing was announced as being Microsoft's replacement for Live Search. This was announced by Microsoft CEO Steve Ballmer at the All Things Digital Conference in San Diego, California. There were a number of new features at the time, including search suggestions when questions were being written along with a list of related searches called Explore Pane. In July of 2009, the companies of Microsoft and Yahoo made a deal in which Bing would power Yahoo's search engine. 6 years later in 2015, the deal underwent some changes. The changes meant that Yahoo was only required to use Bing for a majority of searches. In October of 2011, Microsoft made a statement that they were working on new technology, along with an objective of providing search results at a faster rate, along with being more relevant. In May of 2012, another redesign was announced by Microsoft. The search engine that includes Sidebar was to be redesigned to be better than what it was previously. Fast forwarding to the year of 2020, Bing has become the second most popular search engine that is used. They were also able to generate a revenue of $7.7 billion in the same year. Are you enjoying learning the facts in this video so far? If you are, then be sure to leave a like and visit the channel for more content. For more information, then please read the video description below. Let's take a look at the history of Google. In September of 1998, Google became established by founders Larry Page and Sergey Brin. They both founded the company while they were PhD students attending Stanford University in California. They were able to incorporate Google as a California privately held company on the 4th of September 1998. 4 years later in October of 2002, Google was reincorporated in Delaware. In the year of 2003, the company leased an office complex from Silicon Graphics. This was at 16,000 Amphitheater Parkway in Mountain View, California. This took place after the company outgrew two other locations they were previously based at. Fast forwarding 3 years to 2006, Google purchased the property from SGI for a price of $319 million. It was also at this time when Google was becoming popular and being used among users. In August of 2004, an initial public offering, IPO, took place, and this resulted in Google moving its headquarters back to Mountain View, California. The Google headquarters was nicknamed the Googleplex. The years of 2006 and 2007 saw Google acquire two companies. In October of 2006, Google announced the acquiring of YouTube for $1.65 billion in Google stock. This deal was finalized a month later on the 13th of November. In April of 2007, Google was able to acquire DoubleClick for a price of $3.1 billion. This deal was able to help Google gain valuable relationships that DoubleClick had with web publishers and advertising agencies. Fast forwarding to August of 2015, Google stated some plans to reorganize its various interests as a corporation, known as Alphabet Inc. Google is currently Alphabet's leading secondary company and will continue to be the umbrella company for Alphabet's internet interests. Sundar Pichai was appointed CEO of Google, replacing Larry Page. Page then became the CEO of Alphabet. On the 4th of January 2021, the Alphabet Workers Union was founded, which mainly consisted of Google employees. Since the company's growth and founding, a number of products, acquisitions and partnerships have been launched beyond Google's core search engine, Google Search. There are services based on work and productivity, which are Google Docs, Google Sheets, Slides and Gmail for sending emails. There are also services for scheduling and time management, which are Google Calendar and Google Drive for cloud storage. There are also many more services that are linked with communication, navigation, language translation, video sharing, photo editing and much more. Google is currently leading the development of the Android mobile operating system, the Google Chrome web browser, and Chrome OS, a lightweight operating system based on the Chrome browser. In between the years of 2010 and 2015, Google has moved towards creating hardware. Partnerships were formed among major electronics manufacturers within the production of its Nexus devices. Multiple hardware products were released in October of 2016, examples being the Google Home Smart Speaker, Google Wi-Fi Mesh Wireless Router and Google Daydream Virtual Reality Headset. Google also looked into becoming an internet carrier, examples being Google Fiber, Google Fi, and Google Station. To this day, Google has become the most visited and most popular website in the world. In the year of 2019, Google generated a revenue of around $134.8 billion. I hope you enjoyed learning about the two companies of Google and Bing. Which one do you prefer using? Be sure to leave a comment below. If you did enjoy this video, then be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the BizPage channel for more valuable content. Thank you for watching.